In this topic, we're going to talk about compute services in Azure and how we might connect those through virtual networks. We had a topic talking specifically about virtual networks, and in this one, we want to talk specifically about the PaaS side of that implementation. So if we took a look at a traditional virtual network, if we had our on-prem network, and we have some machines over here that need access to machines up here. Now, when we had IaaS VMs, we could have these VMs up here. We could build either site-to-site or point-to-site. We'll just say site-to-site VPN. Now, these two machines appear to be on the same network, and so they can access each other. That's all great, but what happens if we want to leverage something other than a VM up here? Well, in that scenario, things get a little bit different. So we still have a VNet up here. So our site-to-site has to terminate into a VNet. But we'll talk first, we'll talk through two scenarios. One will be the traditional PaaS, which will be a web or a worker role. And then the second one will be a Azure web app, because they're slightly different in their implementation. So from a PaaS role, you remember that we basically, in a PaaS role, we have a cloud service here, and that's our package. So our application's running up here, and under the covers, we actually have a VM that's servicing that. But we don't have direct access to that VM to start modifying the configuration for the VNet. So how do we set this up? Well, this thing, remember, has a configuration file that comes along with it. So there's a service definition and a configuration that go along with this. And this is just an XML file. And this XML file will control what virtual networks that this thing can be allowed to be in. We can actually control what endpoints are exposed. So the endpoints that are exposed from our cloud service here and which ones are allowed to communicate over that site to site. So we'll define two things. We'll define our VNet and then we'll define the subnet because subnets are built inside of a VNet. And so we can basically set this up in our configuration. And then what happens is when Azure goes to provision this VM in this cloud service, he's going to make sure he puts it in this VNet and he's going to make sure it's in the correct subnet. And once it's in those two things, it looks just like a VM to any other. So our on-prem can connect up through to our cloud service up there. So your traditional PaaS services don't have to go straight over the public internet. This is all internal traffic that we're talking about here. Hmm. Now, the web app is slightly different. So let me walk through a scenario that we run into a lot with web apps. So with web apps, what happens is we'll get our application up here, and let's say this is the web app. Now, web apps by nature and by default are implicitly bound to a public endpoint. So there's always going to be a public endpoint here. We'll just call that PE. And the internet's out here, right? So that's all fine and dandy. Our users can access our website. We can put ACLs around it, just like we talked about before, and these kind of things. But our web app itself is kind of contained here. Now, if we're using, let's say, an Azure SQL database, so the Azure SQL database, if we talk about that, that's the PaaS version of SQL. That, again, also has an implicitly bound public endpoint. So our web app can communicate through that public endpoint, and actually there's an optimization in Azure to optimize that out, but it can connect through there, there's no issues. But what if we have this scenario? What if we have a VNet over here, and we have a VM in here that's running SQL? So this guy is running SQL on IaaS. Well, there's no way for this web app to connect to this VNet, right?
Right.
Actually, there is. There used to not be, but there is now. So the old way was, well, we have to expose a public endpoint here from this guy. Well, that doesn't fly with a lot of organizations, especially enterprise organizations. We don't want SQL on the internet. We only want it internal.
Right.
So in that case, we have a provision now in our web apps where we can build a tunnel between these two. And you can see that in the portal, and you'll see it through some of the implementation, but the implementation is to basically go into your website configuration in a portal and define what VNet you want to connect to. So you basically specify your VNet, and what happens is we're setting up that same tunnel we were talking about before with the site-to-site tunnel. We do the exact same thing for web apps for you. So that's, in a nutshell, that's how we can connect our PaaS compute services through our VNet.
Very nice.
And so that wraps this topic on connecting Azure Compute with virtual networks.